yesterday, and I felt a little sunburn last night. But you know, I've got it today, and I'm ready to go.
I think I hear my friend, the great explorer.
Yep, it's me, and you look all tangled up here, Sydney.
Oh, hi. Thanks for untangling me. I see you're ready to go out on a treasure hunt. What do you have in that bag thingy today?
Oh, same stuff. But I'm also taking my cell phone. I put that in my pocket because I want to take some pictures with it.
Cell phone? Pictures? How about taking one of me?
Okay, that's a great idea.
Hey,
smile.
Peggy.
Oh, that's a good one.
Can I see what I look like?
There you go.
Oh.
Looks pretty good, right? What do you think?
Bad hair day to me. I hope your other pictures turn out better.
Oh, maybe they will. And maybe they won't.
You sound a little discouraged.
I guess I am. You know, I've been trying for 4 whole days to find a treasure out here in the rainforest.
I think you'll do it today. So stop fretting, Peggy. Let's talk about where you are going.
Well, I think the last place to go is Silver Shores.
Silver Shores? Even the name sounds like a treasure.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it? But I don't know. I'm not very hopeful today. But I better get going.
Okay, Peggy. Chin up. Forward ho. On your way. Now go. Go for the treasure.
To the treasure. Well, here we are on the shores of Silver Lake. This looks really cool. I see fish swimming around in there. Have you ever seen a real fish? I had my husband go out and catch a real fish this morning so you could see it. He's pretty slimy. I'm going to bring him over and show him to you. Here. There he is. He's pretty cool. God made fish so beautiful. And when they get big enough, then we can eat them. We're going to throw this one back in the water so he can grow up some more. He's in a pail of water right now. But in our story today, we learn about a miracle Jesus does with fish. And I'm hoping to tell you that. We're just pretending. You know this isn't a real lake, right? But I set it up so that you could try to imagine the story that's in the Bible. We call them stories. But they are real. Everything in this Bible is true and real. But today we're going to just try to imagine and pretend with our lake here, the shores of Silver Lake, and the fire that Jesus sat at. So here goes the story. Oh, before we do that, I think we should sing our gathering song one last time. Since this is day number 5, it's our last time. I bet you can't wait to find out how you're going to come and gather. Be listening really good. Jesus loves us. I always get that tune wrong. Why is that? Does that ever happen to you? Jesus loves us every day. Come and worship Him today. Come explore his words and deeds. They are treasured gems indeed. Come now and gather. Come now and gather. Come now and gather. Come row to me today. Can you row your boat? We row on the water, don't we? Well, that's what our story is about today, is the disciples, those men that Jesus called, they're out fishing again. Even though they don't need to fish for their living, they are fishing probably to have food to eat. We'll light our lantern to help us know and remember that Jesus is with us always. And we will begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, to help us remember that Jesus is with us always. Our story actually begins a little bit ago when Jesus died on the cross. I think all of you might know that story. Jesus was put on the cross to die for our sins. But then on the third day, he rose from the dead, and we call that day Easter. Do you know that word? Easter. Jesus came alive again. And then, even though he wasn't really with his disciples anymore, they weren't following him every day anymore, they were sort of afraid because of what happened to Jesus. But he still went around and showed people that he was alive. He said, "See my hands? I'm alive." Well, one day, imagine this if you will, the disciples were out in their big boat and they were fishing. And remember we said that they use a net to fish with. And they threw that net out and they didn't catch anything, not a single fish. And all of a sudden, there was a man by a fire that hollered, "Throw your net to the other side!" So the fishermen, I can't walk in the water, I'm getting my feet wet. There we go. The fishermen threw their net out to the other side, and guess what? In just a little bit of time, it was full of fish. It was full of 153 fish. It was so heavy, their nets were breaking. And just then, John noticed the man by the fire was Jesus, and he said, "Hey, it's the Lord!" And Peter, he jumps out of the boat, and he ran through the water, and he ran up to see Jesus. They were so happy to see Jesus. And it's like, "Wow, Jesus, you're here with us." And Jesus said, "Yep, I made you some breakfast. I fried some fish for you." Have you ever had fish for breakfast? I don't think I have. And it says in the Bible, he gave them some fish and bread. That bread smells really good. And they sat and ate with Jesus, and they found out he really is alive. But then they sort of questioned him and said, "But Jesus, we want things the way they used to be." And Jesus told them, "I am not going to be with you anymore on this earth, but I will be with you everywhere. You just won't see me." He said, "But I have a special job for you. Remember I asked you to follow me, to learn from me?" And that's what they did. They learned all about what Jesus could do. And Jesus said, "I'm sending a special helper to help you tell everyone about my love. You will have the power to heal, and you will have the power to share God's great love with everyone in the world." And then you know what? Jesus said, "I love you, I treasure you, and I need you to do my work." And guess what? God says that to us too. Even to you, your little, But to your big brothers and sisters, to your moms and dads, to your grandmas and grandpas, he needs us to know his love. And he wants us to share that love with others. He wants us to go into the world and tell others that he's with us. He loves us. He treasures us. That's the real treasure, and that's the best treasure of all that we have found during our vacation Bible school this week. And here we go. Rainforest Explorers, Jesus helps me share this good news because Jesus leads the way. We are going to sing a song right now that reminds us to go, go, go. It's another one that's on your CD. I think it's number 17. We'll sing that. And you can keep on learning these songs, listening to them, watching the DVD to help you do the actions, and have fun with them all the rest of the summer. So. Ready to go, let's go to all the world. To all the world, we have good news to share.
Let's tell our people God is love. Let's show them that we care. Let's care. Let's go, let's care. Let's pray, let's share. Let's go.
And let's close with prayer. Open, shut them, open, shut them, fold them in your lap. Dear God, we thank you for your abundant grace. We thank you for your provision. We thank you that you died and rose again and give us life. Help us go and share this good news. Help us show your love. Help us say kind words and do good deeds. Please protect us and guide us. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, boys and girls, here we are on day 5 of our activity table with our bag, and you'll have day 5 bag from your brown bag. Everything else should be gone and empty. You can take this out. I hope you saved it from last time. And we're going to just take a quick peek at the 5th poster, which I forgot to hang up. I do have it right here. It's the poster of Jesus by the fire saying, "Throw your net to the other side." And that's what the disciples did. And how many fish did they catch? Do you remember? 153. That's a lot of fish in just a little time. It was a miracle. And the disciples were so happy to see him. But that's when Jesus reminded them that he had to go back to heaven to prepare a place for them, but he would be with them even though they couldn't see him. My tongue is getting twisted up. Well, we'll go to the back side and help remember the Bible verse for today, and we'll go to our very last Bible that says, "But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven," Matthew 6:20, verse 20, and we will put our cross on it. Mark it, "But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven." Hi, are you looking for, do you have two? Are you supposed to have two? That's because I have your bag here.
Isaiah's?
Yes. So boys and girls, can you hold on for just a minute? We have somebody picking up their bag yet today. And I was borrowing it to show you what to do. So this is your leaflet. I'm going to skip over to the bag because I have everything else. In your bag, we're just going to skip right over to that. We have our craft. You'll have paper and beginning of the craft. You have your snack, and you do have a scissors in here, so be really careful with that. And last of all, you will have your little clip. So I'm going to go ahead and give that to Isaiah's daddy, and then he can take it home and they can get started on their BBS lessons. So here you go. I just knew that might happen. All right, well, that's great. We're so glad you came to get them. Well, let's go back to our leaflet, and you'll see that the leaflet has the last poster of Jesus sitting by the fire with the men out on the boat fishing. And he says, what did he say? "Throw your net to the other side." And did they obey? Yes, they did. And then they caught a lot of fish. Remember how John said, "It's the Lord, it's the Lord." And Peter jumped in the water and swam up to Jesus. They were so happy to see him. And then they sat with him by the fire and had some fish and bread. And Jesus told them, "I will help you share the good news." Now that little booklet is yours to keep, if you would like to keep it. Our next little booklet, we're just going to scooch right on through it all, is Lesson 5, Jesus Visits His Disciples. I sure hope that you're reading this every day and that you can actually put it all back together in this booklet, and then you have your own little book of 5 Bible stories. In the inside, we have different places that we can go to share the good news and people who can share them or that we can share them with. Jesus wanted the disciples to use their words and their actions to let others know about his love. Well, that's what he wants for you too. Please share your words, share your actions with, that looks like a grown-up man. Maybe he works at the grocery store. This fella looks like he's maybe one of your classmates. Maybe she's your little sister.
That looks like an athlete, somebody who plays soccer. Oh, there's a child playing with his dog. And somebody building blocks. Every time you see somebody new, you can say, hey, did you know Jesus loves you? Or maybe you can offer to help them and they'll say, oh, you're such a nice little person. How come you're so nice? And you can say, that's because Jesus put love in my heart. Because Jesus loves you and he gives you the power to love others. Now there is one last little circle that you can use, your last sticker. Let's see, where is it at? And it is a sticker to help you remember that Jesus also likes to have you talk to him. So when you talk to all these people, you can also talk to Jesus and say, hey, Jesus, I love you, and I know you love me. Thanks for treasuring me. Be sure to talk to him every day. Tell him thank you for everything you have. Now, we're going to move on to our craft without even stopping. If Mom wants to stop in between, you sure can. This craft is just a fun little craft to help you think of the rainforest. You remember you had some sheets of green paper and a scissors. You can cut the green paper into strips. I believe there's a roll of tape in there also. And you can make a chain and attach it to the chain that has been started on your little alligator. Now, do you have to be afraid if you run into an alligator? Well, maybe you should be real careful and not run into an alligator, but if there was an alligator in the rainforest, he would be scary. And we did learn that God made lots of animals in that rainforest because God is so good that he's made lots of wonderful things for us. And here we go, last clip. I happen to have my own clip here. And it says, Jesus helps me share his good news. And on the back is our memory words. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, from Matthew 6, verse 20. Go ahead and clip that on. And it's a good way to share the good news with others. You can let them read it if you forget the words. Have a great rest of the summer, and God bless you. Hi, everyone. Oh, today was way better than I thought it would be. I loved being with you all week and all day today. You know, while we were walking to the Silver Shore, I thought about so many things. And then I met a macaw. Actually, I heard him first, and that's when it happened. I found the treasure. I need to tell Sydney about my wonderful surprise. I wonder where he is. Will you help me call him? Sydney? Sydney the Sloth, where are you?
Oh, I'm just a little tangled up.
Oh, here, let me help.
Hi, Peggy.
Help me, let me help you.
Oh, thank you.
Here,
I can't wait for you to tell me the good news.
Oh.
Did you find that treasure?
Well, yes and no.
What? Not again.
I'll explain, Sydney. You know, I went out to look for the treasure by Silver Shores. I was sure it would be there. And I heard a story about Jesus doing a miraculous thing and feeding the disciples. And I took some pictures while that was all happening. And then I discovered the treasure.
What? Come on, tell me.
Well, I took pictures of all the wonderful things I had seen. The butterflies, the orchids, the monkeys, and the orange tree. See, I have lots of cool pictures. And then I heard the macaw.
You mean that noisy bird?
Yep, that's the one. I listen to his call. Then I listen to all the other sounds in that rainforest. It was pretty noisy. And then I thought about all the Bible stories that we heard this week.
The ones in the book you have?
Yes, the book that I had all week long with me. I thought about God's call to Noah and how God saved him from the flood. I thought about the loving commands he gave to Moses and his people. I thought about how he called the disciples to follow him, how he had mercy on the 10 sick men, and how he helped the disciples know that he would always be with them.
And then?
Then I looked around at what I saw. I realized God had made this beautiful, beautiful place that we were in. All the animals. He even gave me friends like you and all the children that are listening on their devices. Jesus is the treasure. He's my Savior. So that means he treasures me too. He loves me. Yes, Jesus is the treasure who treasures us.
Wow, you were a real explorer. So I'm wondering, what are you going to do now?
Me, my friend Sydney, I'm going on a new adventure with Jesus.
Oh my, what is it?
Well, I'm going to use the power that he's given me in my baptism and the word to share the treasure of Jesus' love with others. I'm going to do my very best to be kind and helpful and let other people know that Jesus loves them and wants them for his children too. So I'm going to begin right now, today. Boys and girls, I hope you will begin right now, today, to be extra kind, extra loving, and to always remember that Jesus loves you, that Jesus treasures you. You can do that even if you're just little. But you know what? When you get big, you can do even more. As you're growing, you can continue to remember Jesus' love and that he's always, always with you. I also want you to think about how you can be Jesus' helper as you get bigger. Maybe you'll be a pastor or a teacher or a really good mommy and daddy who read God's word to your children every day. It's a long ways away, but you know what? Each day that you learn God's word makes you stronger and know his love even more. We're going to close with a song that we have sung several times this week, only we're going to sing it with our tape player, which I forgot to plug in. I'll get it real fast. It's the one that's Allelu, 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 praise ye the Lord. Remember what Allelu means? It means that you are happy, that you are joyful, and that you want to give God the glory. So, take just a minute, and let's sing and dance. We better go back one. We were supposed to be on number 18.
That's okay, Peggy. I like this song too.
I hope the kids play these songs lots and lots of times all summer long.
They can treasure them in their hearts.